telling me you falling out of love with me.
You telling me you falling out of love with me.
Hope you can find someone to love you better than I did.
Hope you can find someone to love you better than I did.
What's good, y'all? It's Simone, and welcome back to another freaking video. If y'all don't know me, like I said, I'm Simone. I'm really trying to get back into it. I'm really trying to get back into posting frequently and basically just doing what I'm telling y'all. Like, I keep saying I'm gonna drop videos and I haven't. I just wanted to be more open with y'all and more raw with y'all, and this is a good way to start it. Some of the stuff I'm about to be talking about is going to be deep. Some of the stuff I'm going to be talking about, y'all may not like. Everyone has their own opinions. If y'all don't like what I say, that is fine. These are my opinions on different subjects. There isn't a particular order I'm going in with these. I just kind of wrote down what I wanted to talk about. There isn't a topic here. Like, I'm just going to be talking about what's on my list. Oh, and y'all are going to be seeing me put on my little acrylics that I took off a while ago. Like, when I get my nails done, if I can, I try to take the nail off whole because I like to glue the sets back on, or try to mix up my sets and then put it on like that, depending on the length and stuff. So, yeah, y'all going to be seeing me do that. So, shout out to my nail tech. And yeah, we're just gonna talk. So let's just jump right into this video. Starting off with opposite genders being friends. So, like, you know, boy and girls being friends, right? I feel like the way society is today, everyone feels like opposite genders can't be friends. And that really bothers me because am I going to be able to talk while doing this? Oh my goodness. Okay. So me personally, I'm not the flirtatious type. I'm not the friendly type. Like, that's not me. But I do have male friends. Only because females, there's just a lot of what in the world? Is this shit? What the actual fuck is going on right now? But yeah, I feel like boys and girls should be able to, like, you know, be friends without society thinking they're together. Like, I could post my best friend or something like that, and they'll be like, "Oh, that's your boyfriend," or "Oh, y'all doing this," or "Oh, y'all doing that," because y'all are best friends. No. Mm-mm. Me and my best friend, that is my man's right there. That's my dog. Like, that's been my dog for years. I just don't understand. Like, there are people out there that will go and be like, "Oh, that's my best friend," and actually be doing stuff with them. That'd be ruining it for people that actually are genuinely friends with the opposite sex. And I'm also not the girly type. Like, I'm more of, y'all don't see this side of me because on social media I model, so y'all don't really see, like, my tomboyish side that almost everyone sees. Like, my family members, my close friends, everyone sees that. It's the way I talk, like, just all that. I tend to bond with males instead of females. And if my female friends that I do have, they are like tomboyish. Like, they're not the girly type. They're not the type to be like, "Oh yeah, like, let's go look for the niggas." Like, no. They are very laid back, talk like dudes. Like, just, that's just, yeah. But this right here, this is the little girly side coming out. Yeah, I dress up here and there, but 98% of the time, I'm wearing sweats everywhere I go. My hair is done all the time, but it's mainly in a scarf or it's mainly in a bonnet because I just like it in a protective hairstyle, but I just don't do anything. Next topic, pick me females. Oh my goodness. Pick me females blow me. And what I mean by pick me females are the females that are like, oh my gosh, like I am so short and I am so this and I am so that. That is what I consider pick me females, and the ones that are always in like boys' faces and are just like, oh, I bet you can't pick me up.
Are you not embarrassed? This is really embarrassing.
It's cringy. It's really cringy. I feel like, I feel like a lot of people have issues with pick me females, and y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. It's very irritating and it's very cringy and it's annoying. I have had a pick me friend, because I'm 5'6" and a half. Okay, let's just say that. I'm 5'6" and a half, and I have a lot of tall friends, but I also have a few short friends, and I had a short friend that always used to compare our heights every time we was around a dude. Like, every time we was around a dude, or every time we was just with each other, she'd be like, oh my gosh, look how tall she is compared to me. I'm so short. I'm so this. I'm so that. And I was just like,
clap if you care. Clap if you care.
All right. Okay. Carry on. And I'm not the only person that feels this way about pick me females. That's just something that y'all just need to chill out. Like, it's really fucking annoying. Now, let's talk about mental health. So mental health is something that I don't want to say that needs to be talked about more, because it really already is talked about a lot. It's more so something that people really should try to, I guess I should say, understand more. Like, because you know, I have my own mental health, and when I was first diagnosed with anxiety and depression at the age of 13, my father didn't really think that I could have it. So when they wanted to, you know, medicate me for it, he didn't want me to take the pills and all that other stuff, and said, like, you know, like, basically, like, I didn't have anything to be stressed out about. Like, I feel like when it comes down to adults basically saying, like, oh, you don't have anything to be stressed about, you're only this age, or you're only this age. Look, let me tell y'all something. If you're struggling with anxiety and depression, I'm telling y'all, you can DM me. Like, I'm telling you, you can DM me, we can talk. When it comes down to anxiety can be an ongoing thing. Like, I have anxiety. And it's something that I work on every single day. And it used to be really, really, really bad. It was bad to the point where I couldn't sleep. Like, I used to get really bad anxiety right before I was getting ready to go to sleep. And it was messing with me. And I would have little anxiety attacks right before I was going to sleep. When it comes down to depression, I feel like depression is way more different than anxiety, because anxiety can be a thing that's like always there, and it's like can be low and can be high, but depression can be a thing that kind of goes away and it comes back and it just sneaks up on you, like out of nowhere. Like, you could be completely fine, you could be happy, and then it just, you know, when you try to talk to somebody about it, it's either, oh, like, you're fine. Like, you were just this 2 hours ago, or you were just this 3 days ago. I just feel like it's something that a lot of people don't understand, or just try not to understand, because they just don't want to hear about it. But yet, people are always like, I want to know what's wrong with you, but you really don't. It's honestly, I feel like that's what makes it hard for people to open up, because when you do, the person is always just like, oh, it's gonna be okay. They don't really want to talk to you about it, if that makes sense. That's why I can say that I am extremely grateful for the friends that I have, and I want to just give them a shout out real quick. The friends that I do have who genuinely helped me get through those tough times, like phases, I don't really know what to call it, because it could last for a few days or a week or some, you know, whatever. I just want to give them a shout out, because those people that were there for me, they genuinely actually talked to me, and it wasn't more so of a, are you okay? It was more so of like, where's your head at? And it was really them trying to understand and really taking the time out their day and taking the time to really listen to me, like listen what was going through my head, listen to my problems, listen to, even if they were very mid, like even if they were very little, at that moment it could have seemed like the biggest thing in the world, and they would really comfort me and really make me feel like I had somebody to lean on. I really want y'all to know, like, I really want y'all to know that y'all can DM me, y'all can talk to me, y'all could text me, because I understand. I do. I understand how it is. I understand feeling lost, feeling, you know, like an unreal in a way, and just helping you guys get through that as well, because I'm telling you, those moments are temporary. Like, one good day can defeat five bad days, you know? So working on your mental health is something that, you know, is a very big thing. I just want to tell y'all, just do not give up, okay? I know it may seem so hard in that moment, but it can be 5 minutes later that something good can happen. Like, I don't even know how to express the way I'm feeling right now, just talking about it to y'all, because I genuinely feel like mental health is something that isn't really getting deep on, because a lot of people don't really know how to discuss it. A lot of people don't know how to talk about it, because everyone is dealing with their own things. Yeah, so basically what I'm saying is, if you want to talk, I'm here. And I'm not just saying that as a person, like, oh yeah, like, you know, just talk to me, like, I'm here. No, like, seriously. Any type of advice you need, any type of a laugh, like, I'm a funny gal. I think I'm a pretty funny gal. Just know that y'all can talk to me. My next topic was going to be about pressure on influencers. I feel like that it's really hard for influencers sometimes, which is why influencers tend to slow down on what they're doing and quit, like, being an influencer, or basically just taking breaks and stuff, because society today is so toxic. Like, it, like, social media is toxic. The people, the kids, it's just so toxic. And I myself can relate to that, because it's like the littlest things can become so annoying. Like, it's not even something that can be serious, but I just feel like influencers can get a lot of, I mean, obviously being an influencer, you're going to get a lot of judgment, but me talking to y'all who are being judgmental on these influencers, y'all claim y'all like them, y'all claim y'all support them, all this stuff that y'all claiming, all this positive stuff, but at the end of the day, y'all are attacking them for things that they like, for things, for who they are, and it's just like, y'all have these high standards for people, and y'all don't even know them in real life. Like, y'all don't know what they're going through, y'all don't know what's going on, and then be surprised when they just stop posting or just want to take a break because it just got so toxic. Yeah, that was just another thing that I wanted to talk about. Woo, okay. Happy weight in relationships. So, my opinion on happy weight in relationships, like gaining happy weight in a relationship, is me personally, I feel like it's a good thing. I don't know how other people feel about it, but I'm guessing that's, you know, it's called happy weight for a reason. Like, it shows that you're happy, like you're eating. A lot of people know that when you're in a bad relationship and you're constantly stressed out, you can lose your appetite, you don't want to eat, and that can last for long periods of time. And I remember talking about it to somebody, and they were like, I would never let, you know, somebody make me lose my appetite. And you can say that, but there are people out here that when you're going through something and you stressed out to that point, it all depends on how your body works. So, I can say myself that I have gone through that. I have. I was in a pretty toxic relationship a few years ago, and I just didn't have the appetite. And I can't even sit here and be like, I was hungry, because I wasn't really hungry. You would think I was, because I just wasn't eating, but the only thing I ate was Reese's. It was like my stress food. It was like my comfort food. I didn't eat anything else but Reese's. And I remember I posted a picture not too long ago, like, saying, I used to be addicted to eating Reese's. Y'all, I was not addicted to eating Reese's. It was my comfort food, because I was getting out of a bad breakup. I didn't have the appetite to eat anything, but for some reason, I could just eat Reese's. And that was the only thing I was eating for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. But happy weight, good stuff right there. I feel like that is some good stuff, because that means, you know, they taking care of you. You eating, you got an appetite, girl. You want to, yeah, as you should. Yeah. And that could go for both man and woman. Happy week. Yeah. Fake friends, y'all. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about fake friends. It can either be something you can see in the beginning, or it can be something you see in the middle. But there are red flags. There can be a ton of red flags. And it's up to you if you choose to ignore them. Now, I've had a decent amount of fake friends in my life. But if I saw the signs, it was up to me if I wanted to continue being friends with them, or if I wanted to cut them off and just move on. But me, y'all, I can honestly say that I tend to have an attachment issue to people, whether it is relationships or friendships. I can have an attachment problem with people, and that is something that I work on today, and I've gotten much better at it, because somebody could do me so wrong, but my love for them, my attachment for them, could like completely take out what they did to me, or the bad part of them, or just, you know, stuff like that. Yeah, when it comes down to fake friends, let me just tell y'all, if y'all are seeing red flags in somebody, whether it's a relationship or if it's friends, just, you know, just cut it off. Y'all can be friends for a long period of time, a short period of time. I know it can be hard because of the love and the bond that you've built with that person, but y'all, if the signs are red, run the other way. Like, it's, or else you could be in talking to your therapist about it. Like, that's just something. y'all already know. Y'all, I'm gonna be talking with my nails. I'm going to be talking with my nails for the next however long I'm about to be talking. So, y'all, obviously, this was supposed to be nude, but it's not, so it is what it is. So this is how my nails look. Very cute, very, very cute. So shout out to my nail tech, because I haven't had nails on in like a few weeks, and I missed it. Yeah, I had to do my hair before I put the nails on. Anyways, next topic. Friends that are fake supportive. My goodness, did I want to talk about this one. So, becoming an influencer. Like, y'all know that I am an influencer on social media. Getting to that goal and getting to where I am now, I've gone through a lot of fake supportive friends. And it was just a lot of secret animosity. And it got to the point where I felt like I couldn't even be happy for myself around them. Like, I couldn't talk about my goals. I couldn't talk about my accomplishments. Like, just stuff that I wanted to talk to my friends about, that I was genuinely proud of myself for, that I just couldn't. To this day, I only talk about my accomplishments and stuff to about 2 or 3 people. It's something that is sad, because you really want to talk about your accomplishments to your friends, but it could be the tone of their voice. It could be how they rub it off. Like, say you bring up your goal, right? You like, oh my gosh, like, I just got a new job. And they're like, you're probably going to end up quitting in a week. Like, it's like, huh? Like, what are you talking about? Or you're like, oh, I got this role for this movie. I doubt that show even is going to take off. I'm about to hit you in your... What do you mean? Like, what do you mean? Like, you can't just be like, congratulations? You can't say congratulations? Is it hard? Is it hard for you to say congratulations? Like, am I not understanding? Or you got people that, when you try to say something good about yourself, they turn it on to themselves. Like, oh yeah, girl, like, I got a new car. Oh, for real? I'm getting a better one in a week. Who the fuck asked? Who asked? Not me. So yeah, basically all I'm saying is, watch out for those type of friends, because y'all don't need them type of negative people in y'all life who don't have nothing positive to say. Backhanded compliments, terrible. Very, very terrible. I don't know if y'all really get what I mean by backhanded compliments, but I've gotten those a few times, and you'll know a backhanded compliment when you hear one. It's basically a compliment that's not a compliment. It's a compliment hidden with some animosity inside of it, like with some ignorance inside of it. Watch out for them people too, because y'all don't need them people in y'all life either. Let's talk about them females that be picking their dude over their friends. Y'all, look. When you get a dude, I understand. You always want to be with your man. That, I completely understand that, okay? Say you out with your friends, right? You out with your friends, and all they're talking about is their dude. Like, do you live anymore? Like, that's all you talk about. Like, it's like, oh yeah, girl, like, oh, let's go get some ice cream. Me and my man just got ice cream last week. Okay, all right. So what ice cream do you want? Oh, I want chocolate, because my man like chocolate ice cream. You don't even like chocolate ice cream. You're allergic to chocolate. Oh, it's okay. My man can just take me to the hospital. What? Bougie females. Yeah. When it comes down to certain females, like, y'all know what I mean by bougie. Like, the females that think they're better than everyone else. Like, the females that think they are superior than everyone else. We all just out here trying to live. We all out here trying to do our thing, live life, be happy. Or the females that say you compliment a female, right? And they leave you on scene. Now I'm taking my compliment back. Now I'm taking my compliment back, because what? Yeah. A lot of y'all don't even be bougie, like, because I get told that I seem bougie because of my face. I have what people call a resting bitch face. Like, when I'm out, I don't smile. But it doesn't mean like I'm mad or anything. And then people don't like to come up to me because I have a resting bitch face, and I'm just like, the whole time I'm like the sweetest person ever. Like, I, like, you can come speak to me. Then again, I'm not really that much of a people person, so I don't know about all that one, but I'm not mean, and I'm also not bougie. I do see a lot of females that look like they have attitude, and they really could be like the really sweetest people, and that's how people see me. But I actually mean, I really do mean like the actual people that be having attitude. Like, so you talk to them, they just like, hi, like, okay, okay. Disrespecting teachers and older people. If you're one of those people that likes to disrespect teachers for fun, you lost my respect. Yeah. You lost my respect, hands down. Because why are you disrespecting a teacher? Like, if that was your mother, if that was your mother, your grandmother, your father, your grandfather, whatever, uncle, aunt, you wouldn't want somebody disrespecting them. And then it'd be unneeded, dumb, childish stuff that y'all be saying. Like, that's one of, that's like up there. Like, that's up there for me. Like, it's so annoying when people disrespect teachers. Like, grow up, for real, grow up. Because why do you think it's funny to sit there and disrespect the teacher? Like, because y'all would really be ready to go to war if y'all seen another kid or whatever disrespecting your mother or your father. So, yeah. Disrespecting your girlfriend or disrespecting your boyfriend, whatever. Respect goes both ways, okay? Putting your hands on them is not cool. I feel like it's not talked about enough when it comes down to females putting their hands on men because they're a female. But at the end of the day, respect goes both ways. Because if a male puts their hands on a female, they're going to go to jail or they're... Like, it's just a whole bunch of stuff. But when a female puts their hands on a male, there's nothing a male can do. But when a male snaps, then it's like, oh my gosh, you put your hands on me. But you were just slapping him. You were just hitting him with the bat. Like, basically what I'm saying is disrespecting your significant other, like putting your hands on them, calling them out their name, it goes both ways. Respect goes both ways. When it comes down to men calling their female the B word and all this stuff, y'all is dead wrong. Whether y'all is joking or whatever, at the end of the day, it's wrong. Okay, it's not respectful, it's not cool, it's not cute, it's just, it's not cool at all. It's just not, like, y'all know that word is not cool. So why are you calling somebody you mess with or somebody you like or somebody you love a bitch? Like, So I'm gonna need you throw that toxicity away, because that's not cool. It's not cool at all. All right, y'all, but that was the end of this video. I honestly don't think this was more of a unpopular opinions video. It was more of a just talking about random subjects that I feel like need to be talked about, or I just wanted to talk about. I hope y'all enjoyed it. If y'all didn't like what I said, then that is completely okay. Everyone has their own opinions. These were just my opinions on things. I hope y'all like, comment, and subscribe. I will be dropping videos more frequently, because y'all did say that y'all would want to watch like daily vlogs and stuff. Basically, y'all can get like a more raw version. I mean, like, day-to-day kind of thing of what, like, y'all see, like, me, you know? Like, comment and subscribe. Comment down below what kind of videos y'all want to see other than vlogs. And, I think I'm gonna do some pranks, because people don't be doing pranks that much anymore, you know? So, actually, people do be doing pranks, but still, anyways, that was the end of the video. And, yeah. Bye!
No, I love it. Yeah, I love you. Ain't nothing better for